Welcome.
Welcome
to the celebrated nightly news of Calaveras County. My name's John.
And I'm Sarah.
And we thank you for dropping by on a balmy and warm Thursday evening.
That's
it
right.
Almost felt
like Hawaii.
Summerish.
Yes.
Like Hawaii?
Yes.
Oh.
Hawaii when it's not quite so balmy.
All right.
Balmier than it is here.
And I want to apologize off the top. If you're looking for a nice something on the background, my little... And it's right. It always happens like 30 seconds to airtime. Something's going to... It'll be working just perfect for days. And then all of a sudden...
Nothing.
So we'll just play with it here. So anyway.
It's kind of like Murphy's Law.
Murphy's Law. But, exactly. You know, that doesn't work here because in our area, though, there
Murphy's
is the luck
is
of... They're always lucky.
And Murphy's?
Oh, have you ever noticed that, like, for example, like a year ago's Irish Days Parade?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that
it
window.
It was raining like... It was just like cats, dogs, pitchforks,
yes.
hay bales, just going like mad. Half hour before parade,
nothing.
Dried up. Ran...
And then
right
afterwards,
the end,
boom, right
there it goes.
That's
so
what
I
happens
think...
every year. If it's bad weather at the Irish Days Parade, right before the parade, it stops. Like the snow one year, it was just a couple years ago. The snow stopped, had the parade, and the snow began again.
There we go.
And that was in March. Irish Days. Snow. So...
Hey, what do we got going on tonight?
What do we have going on tonight?
We're gonna do our.
Normally,
we'll tell you what to do.
Exactly.
Because we have this strange belief that
somebody
you'll
listen to us.
Yeah, it's just because this is hopefully informative to tell you what's going on this weekend.
That's right.
What is worthy to spend your precious minutes and hours
That's
on?
That's right.
Out.
Your time.
Because we wouldn't want you frittering away your time.
That's right.
We
Much
want,
like,
as we were doing, we were playing.
We
with,
don't like
we don't,
fritter
we want
away
you to be,
our time either.
And we want you to be parsimonious in a good way,
That's
right?
That's right. Parsimonious. And what is parsimonious, John? Pray tell. What does parsimonious mean?
Well, I think, you know, economy in
economy
a good way, right?
To spare.
Yes.
Right? Economy in a good way.
Yeah. And this
we
thing's
want you
still
to economize your time.
Up.
But before we get to that. The sheriff's office has actually released some interesting numbers. A report actually on the early release and rearrest from January 2007
yeah.
through September 30th, 2007. So these are actually very immediate.
Very interesting data.
And what's interesting in that 9 and a little bit months, almost 10 months, there were 1,589 releases from the Calaveras County Jail. And 480 of those were early releases. And of those early releases, 242 were rearrested.
So not only was there a 50% recidivism.
Release. Exactly. And typically...
But these crimes were committed... Well, they still should have been in the pokey
exactly.
in the first place.
Exactly. It's my understanding that the rearrests typically take place while they were supposed to be spending time in jail.
Wow.
So, here's another reason why we need a new jail. Exactly. So, in case you haven't heard, there will be a ballot initiative on the November 6th ballot for Measure J, which
you've been
would,
hiding under that rock.
That's right. That's right. Which would provide funding... for a new jail and a new sheriff's facility attached to the new jail, and also miscellaneous costs. Now, $10 million of that $30 million bond measure will go towards new jail construction and will be used by the sheriff's department to apply for grant funding from the state. And the grant funding, if we can get the $10 million from the bond, would be in the amount of $30 million for this new jail. So it's
wow.
just sort of amazing. Spend a little and get a lot.
And we figured it out. Didn't we do the math? And what is it? Basically 17 cents a day?
That's right.
Or something
That's
like that.
That's all we ask
yes.
is 17
it's
cents
something
a day.
Like, you know how you know, the charities always, the worldwide charities, they... You know, for only so many pennies a day, you can feed the hungry and the
That's stuff. Right. That's
this
right.
is a twist on that. So for only 17 cents a day, you can house a local criminal. Well,
that's
we
right.
know it costs
Not
a lot more
house.
Than that. We know it costs a lot
more
than
that.
But
exactly.
I mean, for the
For the bond measure.
Yes. So absolutely. for only mm-hmm. 17 cents a day, you can house
a criminal who should not be released early anyway. But absentee ballots have actually gone out, and if you've received those, go ahead and fill them out and send them back in.
Yes, and run on that in an unbiased, middle-of-the-road right. journalistic style, right?
We'll tell you to vote yes.
We're telling you to vote yes on it, right? Isn't that the...
well, we won't do it subtly like the other news organizations. We'll just tell you what we think.
Oh, so we're not going to try to be unbiased or anything? We're just going to tell you just to vote yes.
We're just telling you this is what we think you should vote. Yes.
We've doomed the measure. We've doomed the measure to ultimate failure, right?
I hope not.
Just kidding.
I hope not. So vote yes. And if these numbers are not unusual at this point. Numbers like this have been showing up every year for years now. And the sheriff's department and the sheriff have been trying to get new jail funding for longer than I can remember, which is just amazing.
And her memory is elephant-esque.
Sometimes, yes. And what do you have over there?
A blank screen. I have a blank screen.
You have a blank screen.
I have a blank screen.
Ooh, okay.
And I guess for our, who are we going to, I know,
what's
we on? Were going to touch a little, we were going to go over this weekend's events, but also touch a little bit on some of the Halloween.
On the Halloween events.
Halloweenish stuff too.
Exactly.
Because,
so let me get to Friday events.
I guess the Board of just a little bit on recap. Mm-hmm. Board of Supervisors meeting is up, all 4 hours of it. We will put the...
scintillating television.
Yes, we will put the study session up so you can watch it from the pinetree.net a little bit later this evening.
That's right.
So...
And that will show on Channel 9.
Channel 9 probably already is tonight, huh?
It probably already is tonight in Channel 9.
I think that was only a couple hours, so it was actually
not too bad.
Brief.
Yeah.
And I am just locked up like...
Boy, maybe... Oh, you can't even shut down your computer. Okay. I will go to the calendar.
Calendar, here we go.
Where
we tell you what to do.
Exactly. In the vain thought that you might listen to us. So... Angels Camp Library Children's Artwork Display is still on display.
Maybe we should take the approach of like for parenting.
What's that?
Tell them not to go.
Oh. Does that still work, do you think? It's that whole reverse psychology thing. Exactly. Yeah. You're going to want to do exactly what someone tells you not to do.
Right.
It is the nature of human nature.
It is.
Absolutely.
So,
anyway,
we're going to tell you where not to go.
That's right. Don't go to the library.
Yeah.
So you won't see Mrs. Aroler's kindergarten class from Mark Twain Elementary School, their artistic abilities.
Great.
That's at the Angels Camp Library. And that will be through the month of October. And let's see. Fresh Fridays is still going on.
Still going.
And
probably... And we've heard that it is starting to taper a little bit just because of some of the vendors and it's, but.
5:30.
All right.
5:30. That's our little producer person.
Yes.
Coming to give us news. More news. So, but anyway, 5:30 Utica Park for Fresh Fridays. Also Saturday. It's kind of a light weekend this weekend.
It is?
Yeah, it's a little light. Open Garden Day, 10 a.m., San Andreas, at the Government Center. And if you've never actually seen the Master Gardeners demonstration there, it's worth a gander, quite frankly.
It is.
It really is. They've done a beautiful job there. And the Open Garden Day is for 4 hours. And the Master Gardeners are there to available to actually answer questions about gardening in the Mother Lode, in Calaveras County, and the different regions within the county. And that will be from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And that is actually through the UC Cooperative Extension. And 10 a.m., Trail of Natural Bridges Hike.
Great. Join Park Ranger Alex...
In Coyan.
Coyan, on a hike to the Coyote Creek and the Upper Natural Bridge. Mm-hmm. Ranger in Coyan will focus on the identification of trees and animal tracks.
Let's hope they don't see mountain lions.
That's true.
We don't want to see mountain lion tracks. But pets are not permitted on the trail. It's a 1.5 mile hike with a few short, steep, and rocky areas. And you will meet at the trailhead at Natural Bridges on Parrots Ferry Road. And bring a trail, snacks, and water. And hiking shoes and appropriate clothing. Appropriate clothing. So we want
now, do they still have lack of clothing in that area?
I think so sometimes. Why, did you go down there and find people with lack of clothing?
I was like 10 years old, I was on a hike, and we're like this little, Boy Scout thing, you know, cruising up over the road. And this is the mid 70s when there was more of that
free and easy time anyway.
And everybody was hiking boots that's it. Yeah. You ever notice that for most people who enjoy the
outdoors.
En naturel type.
Uh-huh.
Most of them really need clothes.
Oh.
You know, clothes are usually a good thing for most people. You know, it's...
I was just going to give you that rope and let you swing.
Yeah.
I'm not touching that with a 10-foot barge pole.
Yeah, we better... Yeah, you're... The puns are...
Yeah, uh-huh. One-stop shopping event in Murphy's at 11 on Saturday. These are direct sales consultants from different companies.
Right.
And that will be from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. at the Native Sons Hall in downtown Murphy's. And there's vendors like the Pampered Chef, Lagerburger Baskets, Princess House, Beauty Control, Artistry and Gift Books, World Ventures and Creative Memories, as well as Gold Canning Candles. So there's all sorts of these vendors there.
Stuff.
Exactly. There's sort of, actually, it'd be kind of nice to go and look for Christmas gifts early this year.
Uh-huh.
And fall fashion show. Actually, this is always a good
thing. I just had to restart it. I was kept playing with it here.
That's
totally.
Why we
it's
have
just
a,
now you
IBM ThinkPad.
IBM, there
now
we
you
go.
Know
yeah.
What kind of
so,
computers we use.
It was like 20 seconds till and boom,
Died.
All right.
Just died. Anyway, Calaveras Big Trees Association Fall Fashion Show. And this is actually at the Snowflake Lodge in Blue Lake Springs. It begins at 11:30, and it includes lunch, and it supports the interpretive programs
at
Big Trees.
It is a fun-filled event.
Mm-hmm. It is. It is very nice. 11:30.
Now, have you ever done any modeling in your past?
As little as possible.
As little as possible?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Every once in a while, they try to pull me into the fashion shows here, and every once in a while, I'll do it, but not very often.
See, as you can tell from my on-camera persona, I've never done any modeling, and no one's ever
Nobody's
asked.
Nobody's asking.
Please stay away from the camera. Stay away from the camera.
Also, 1 p.m. paper mache mask making class.
There we go. Popular local artist Lori Williams will be teaching the 3-hour class on paper mache mask making in the classroom of the Folk Arts Center in Pine Grove on Saturday, October 27.
At 1 o'clock?
At 1 o'clock with a follow-up meeting to be arranged at Saturday workshop.
Mm-hmm. So that you can paint the masks after you make them. The cost is $70, and you can call 223-3322 to find out more information. And apparently, she is a paper mache artist.
Very nice.
Did you do paper mache when you were a kid? Because that was that 70s thing, too.
Thank you.
I did paper mache.
I didn't do any paper mache.
I did paper mache.
I didn't.
We made a paper mache pig.
A paper mache pig?
Yeah, we took a balloon and blew it up and put paper mache around it and then popped the balloon and
see,
pulled it out.
See, my time, since I grew up on a farm, a lot of my free time...
Oh, you saw free... True pigs.
Yeah, but
real live
a lot
pigs.
Of my a lot of my free time was
feeding the pigs.
We didn't have pigs.
Oh, you
didn't. We
just
had chickens.
And cows.
We had cows, and we had little calves and
little calves.
Yeah, and we don't have time for a story, do we?
Maybe at the end. and on to the next event.
Otherwise, I'm going to start talking about.
Cows.
Instead of pigs, cows flying instead of
pigs
or,
and,
yeah, we don't
yes,
want that.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
not a good thing.
Okay, 6 o'clock, flautist Mary Youngblood is in the Moaning Cavern, and she's actually an Emmy Award winning.
Wow.
Is it Emmy? No, it's not Emmy.
Grammy.
Grammy. Oopsie-daisies, thinking Emmys.
She's going to be flouting.
We may be up for an Emmy.
Will she be flouting?
She will be flouting at Inside Moaning Cavern.
We flouted that one up.
Yes, we did. 6 p.m. to 7:30. And let's see, Inside the Cavern in Moaning Cavern in Vallecito. That's off of Parrots Ferry Road. Tickets are $24.95 for space in the cavern and $14.95 for space at the top.
On top of the stairway?
Of the 100-foot spiral staircase.
Can you imagine what the acoustics are going to be like in there?
They would be pretty amazing. Oh,
just incredible.
You know, sort of an interesting little trivia tidbit about Moaning Cavern is that it's so tall you could fit the Statue of Liberty in it.
Interesting.
If you could get her down.
If you
the
could
hole.
Get her down, if you could shove
yeah.
her down the
exactly.
Yeah.
Okay. The shaft.
The Statue of Liberty just got the shaft, but yeah, anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
you
just
could
kidding.
Fit her in there if you so chose, apparently.
If you so chose.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And 6:30 Community Design Workshop for Valley Springs. This will, let's see, Saturday, October 27th. This is actually a follow-up meeting. Or is this in the wrong space? On Wednesday, October 24th, 6:30 to 9.
And
October Saturday,
27th.
October 27th. That
at
is,
2 p.m.
So this is,
so
the,
this
follow-up
is the afternoon.
Meeting, 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. The Local Government Commission will hold their second of a two-part series on community design for Greater Valley Springs.
Great.
And admission is free. And myvalleysprings.com is actually sponsoring the event.
And they are very active down there.
They are very active.
They are very
actually.
Active.
And actually, it was grant funding that is funding the
week.
This
is kind of nice with my computer now, because that way Sarah has to do all... She's carrying this broadcast.
I have to
I'm
just
sitting
do
over
all
here
the talking and
playing
reading.
With my mouse.
Yes,
and
yes. If you want more information about this meeting, call Joyce Teckel at 772-1463 or Josh Meyer at 916-448-1198, extension 310. And you can look at the calendar on thepinetree.net and find out more information about that as well. And finally, 9 p.m. On Saturday evening, James Faithfull, is that how you pronounce that?
Must be.
And the Jukes Blues Band is going to be at the Murphy's Historic Hotel.
Blues, jazz,
blues,
funk,
jazz.
With some original songs and some standard blues songs.
Mm-hmm.
Costume contest.
And this five-piece blues band is from Twain Hart, 9 p.m. to 1 a.m. or 2 a.m., obviously depending on the crowd.
Depending on the crowd.
That's right. That's right. And a costume contest will be held there as well, so people can get
very
in
nice.
The mood for Halloween a
we,
few days early.
Our kids dressed up in costumes last night, so everybody's
right.
getting started.
They're getting started a little early.
Last night there was at the Chapel in the Pines, they had their Awana
family,
fall.
Yeah, family fun festival.
And so there was little kids and ghosts and
mm-hmm.
goblins and...
That's right.
Nachos and...
Lots and lots of kids.
Hot dogs and lots
mm-hmm.
of kids.
Lots of kids. Okay, Sunday, 12 p.m., noon, Mark Twain Elementary School Pumpkin Patch
John,
Carnival.
Just, if you don't
yes,
have to
John, nachos
to say,
and hot dogs. Yes,
just,
typical
just
family fun fest fair, right? the Mark Twain Elementary School in Angels Camp, sixth grade class, is raising money for their science camp, and they are actually sponsoring this Pumpkin Patch Carnival. It will be held at the Spence Ranch Feed and Supply, and that is actually somewhat at the end of town in Angels Camp. It's Altaville. And let's see here.
They have lots of pumpkins there. Have you driven past? Did you notice?
I've not driven past.
If you've driven that way on Highway 49, you'll see lots and lots and lots of pumpkins.
Mm-hmm.
They're ready. Hay
you
and
know,
pumpkins.
A few years ago, there was a pumpkin shortage. Did you know that?
A
maybe,
pumpkin shortage?
Yes. Maybe you weren't hunting for pumpkins for your boys.
No.
But during that time, the pumpkin growers, farmers, actually had to put video surveillance on their crops because people were stealing their
pumpkins. Stealing the great pumpkin.
They were stealing the great pumpkins. Anyway, hot dogs will be on sale, and admission is $5 per child, and families of three or more will be $15, and that's, again, at the, Mark Twain Elementary School Pumpkin Patch Carnival.
Which is at Spence, right?
Which is at Spence, And there'll be decorating pumpkin contests and everything. So it's kind of a cool thing. And 1:30 p.m. on Sunday, Business Ben's Fellowship USA. That's in San Andreas. Rally and a Banquet begins at 1:30.
Rally and a Banquet.
$20 a ticket. And
it's at the Met.
Yes, it is. And Banquet is actually at 6 p.m. So that's at the Met. And Danny Diaz will be speaking. He was a former singer and entertainer in Nevada.
Former.
Yeah.
Do we know why he's former?
Hear how he overcame his addiction to alcohol and became a powerful voice for God.
Got it.
So
okay.
Maybe
he needed a lifestyle change. Huh?
Exactly.
Yeah,
he's
okay.
Not. Maybe he doesn't perform in Nevada anymore. He performs other places. Okay.
They didn't kick him out of Nevada, did they?
I don't think so.
I mean, if you get kicked out of Nevada, you've done.
That's
some...
pretty. Yeah.
I'm sorry.
yes. Okay, Wednesday, October 31st, we're going to give you a little... Oh, wow. Where are all our Halloween events?
All of our Halloween events? Maybe they did...
Well, let's go to
The Murphys. Well, the Murphys, the big one is the Murphys. If you're new to the area or visiting, unless they've trick-or-treated in the Rocky Hill section of Murphy's, you haven't trick-or-treated.
Oh, I'm sure the homeowners are going to be excited about us telling the rest of the county about it. What they do is they actually close off the road, and they have sort of volunteer sheriffs there to keep order.
Right.
And it is jam-packed with kids in their costumes and parents taking their kids around. And it's quite a sight to behold.
Don't you think this is one of those things where it is another slice of... I mean, every once in a while, Murphy's, you know, gets one of those one of the top 10 coolest small town type of things.
Yeah,
it does.
And this probably
this one is deserved because this is typical small town Americana.
Oh, yeah.
The local businesses get together. They help donate candy.
That's right.
They block off the streets. Mm-hmm. And there's literally thousands of little... Because, you know, most people think, oh, yeah, we'll go trick-or-treating and go knock on a few doors and, hey, this light's on. And they actually do more decorating for this than they do for Christmas.
And
I mean,
people
this
decorate
is just,
their houses.
Yeah,
and there's
it is
actually,
really...
There's one house that's off in the corner at the very top of Rocky Hill Road. I think that's still Rocky Hill Road. It's right in that cul-de-sac.
Not Rocky Horror. Did they name it Rocky Horror for the...
I don't
they
know,
should.
But they should, too.
Yeah,
they?
That
should
be Rocky Horror Road.
That's right. That's
all
right.
I'll
but they
be quieter.
They decorate so elaborately every year. It's amazing what they do with their yard. It just is amazing. You just can't believe what they do. They have coffins and they have, you know, what are they, ghosts and stuff?
Ghosts
swinging
and goblins
around
and
from the trees. And they had a big spider that moved last year. That's right. One of those big giant ones.
It is. It's truly amazing. So even if you're up here visiting, stop by. Go out there. Even if you're not a kid.
That's right. And
if you're just a kid at heart.
That's right. And there's one house where I finally found out who the owner of the house was, but I can't say who it is because they want to remain anonymous. But they carve fabulous pumpkins every year.
Oh, they really do.
They do.
Yeah,
it's,
I know
it's
which
amazing.
House that is.
Yes, exactly. It's absolutely amazing. So it's worth going out and taking a look. But just don't tell anybody we told you to do it.
Why?
Because
then
we'll have the Rocky Hill homeowners people after us. That's
See, maybe we should tell them not to do it because we're hoping.
That's right. Don't go.
Yeah,
don't go.
Yeah, this is because, you know, we don't want to.
That's right. We don't want
to. We're trying
to
use the reverse
people.
Psychology
yes, that's
here,
right?
Isn't that the.
That's right. And the third annual Halloween Blast at the Bear Valley Lodge is taking place on October 31st. It's a buffet beginning at 5 p.m. and a scary movie to follow at 5:30.
A scary movie.
Mm-hmm. Games at about 6 p.m. and a scary story at 7. So trick-or-treating at 7:15, music, live music by Blue Shoes at 8 p.m. And that
they're kind of the unofficial house band of the Bear Valley Lodge.
The Blue Shoes?
The Blue Shoes. They do a great job.
Blue Shoes.
They
Let's
do. They're
here.
The unofficial. They were playing at the...
If John had his
I'll
computer
just be quiet.
Up... If John had his computer up, they could.
We could actually show you the very cool Blue Shoes
little flyer they've made up. So looks like a Grateful Dead flyer, actually.
You know, I'm just about back up, believe it or not.
Are you? Wow. Okay.
It only took the entire news broadcast to get it all put
back
together.
That's right. Actually, you know, we need to go to weather.
We do?
Yeah.
Oh, we do. It's that time. Oh, man.
It is that time. Weather. All
right, weather.
Going to weather now. Weather. Weather, weather, weather. Okay,
there we
Arnold,
go.
Weather.
And we have...
Friday, it's 66 degrees. Oh, it's getting chillier.
It's going to drop a little bit.
Saturday, 69 degrees, and Sunday, 72
Since
degrees.
Since you plugged it, we better at least show them the flyer.
That's right.
Here we go. Here is the colorful and exciting Halloween...
Oh.
At the Bear Valley Lodge, Blue Shoes.
See, this is like the little Grateful Dead people.
The Grateful Dead.
Yeah, there you go.
There we go.
Bear Valley Lodge.
Bear Valley Lodge.
Mm-hmm. Bear Valley weather. Friday, 61 degrees. Saturday, a high of 65 degrees. And Sunday, a high of 69 degrees. And Murphy's weather.
See, as she talks, I'll do my best little
That's
band
right.
of white here.
That's
here
right.
we go.
Friday.
Murphy's.
76 degrees.
76
Saturday,
degrees.
Saturday, 79 degrees.
79 degrees.
Sunday, a high of 81 degrees. And Angels Camp weather. Friday, a high of 75 degrees. Saturday, a high of 76. And Sunday, a high of 75. So.
For our friends in Bangor, Maine.
Bangor, Maine.
It is 56 today. Probably not still. With a low of 29 degrees, 57
mm-hmm.
degrees tomorrow with a low of 43, 61 with some showers on
wow.
Saturday, and 56 degrees and 30 on Sunday.
Oh, my goodness.
So it's going to be chilly
low.
Out
it's
getting those lobster
chilly.
Pots. Out.
That's right. That's right. And in Valley Springs, Friday will be 77 degrees, Saturday a high of 77 with some low clouds, and Sunday a high of 78 with some more low clouds.
And for our friends in Copperopolis,
mm-hmm.
78 degrees tomorrow, 78 degrees on Saturday, and 78 degrees on Sunday. So if you're looking to know what temp it's going to be in Copperopolis, it's going to be 78.
78, that's right. All weekend long.
It'll be 78 degrees.
It'll be 78 degrees. And I have just...
And the question, whatever the question is for weather this weekend, it's going to
be
78.
It'll be kind of nice, actually.
Yeah, it'll be 78.
Let's see. And you're still working on that?
No.
Okay.
We better. You're right.
Let's see here. Let's see if I can find an interesting little tidbit before we sign off. Company sells fake excuse notes.
Fake excuse notes?
Yes. Let me see. It says content is loading. So... Feeling like playing hooky but nervous about getting caught? There is the Excused Absent Network, which will sell you $25 excuse notes that appear to come from real doctors or hospitals.
So you may want
to
go on
to
and,
get you out
and
of
check
work.
Those,
exactly.
Check those doctors' numbers.
That's right. That's right.
And also, a little bit, we've had some requests. If mm-hmm. on the fires, it looks like they're starting to get a little bit of an upper hand on them out in
yes.
Southern California.
Yes.
One of the things is they're asking that if your donations and for helping,
mm-hmm.
money's the best way.
Yeah.
We post a little article here on, let's see, we'll pull this up. Some of the different, let's see, there was a list. So if you go to thepinetree.net and
mm-hmm.
click down, there's actual numbers and website addresses
mm-hmm.
from a lot of the different, you know, the American Red Cross, if you want it more locally, there's the San Diego branch. Goodwill, different ones like that that are actually working hard on it. So,
mm-hmm.
because right now, until they get into permanent housing, until they know where they're going to do and
exactly.
stuff like that, household items, it's like, well, I'm sitting in the middle of Qualcomm Park, but thanks
yes.
for the shoes.
Yeah, exactly.
So money is a little, probably a little
probably
more.
Probably a little
yeah,
more.
So,
exactly.
Anyway. We thank you very much
mm-hmm.
for joining us. We really do.
And
we hope you
weekend.
Have a great weekend, and we'll probably see you out and about. And if you see us, you can say hi
That's
or
right.
trip us or throw
hi.
Something. Or
just say hi.
Just say hi.
Yes. Yeah. Good night.
Thank you very much. Good night.